The following is an arrival address given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on June 20th, 1975 in Los Angeles.
Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama. We have no new discovery. We don't manufacture. This is our process. We simply follow the predecessor minister. That's our movement is very easy because we haven't got to manufacture something. We simply repeat the words and the instruction given by the predecessor. Krishna instructed Brahma, Brahma instructed Narada, Narada instructed Vyasadeva, Vyasadeva instructed Madhyacharya, and in this way, then Madhavendra Puri, Ishwar Puri, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then the six Goswamis, then the Srinivasa Acharya, Kaviraj Goswami, Narottam Das Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti, Jagannath Das Babaji, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Gaurakishore Das Babaji, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, and then we are doing the same thing. There is no difference. That is the specific procedure of the Krishna consciousness movement. You are singing daily Guru Bukha Padva Vakka Chitete Koriya Oiko. Arna Koriya Mane As. Very simple thing. We are receiving the transcendental knowledge through Guru Parampara, succession. So we have to simply take instruction from Guru, and if we execute that to our heart and soul, that is success. That is practical. I have no personal qualification, but I simply try to satisfy my Guru. That's all. My Guru Maharaj asked me that if you get some money, you print books. So, there was a private meeting, talking, some of my important godbrothers also there, it was in Radhakunda. So, Guru Maharaj was speaking to me, that since we have got this Madhvaja marble temple, there has been so many dissensions. Everyone thinking we occupy this room or that room, that I wish therefore to sell this temple and the marble and print some book. Yes. So he took up this from his mom, that he is very fond of books. And he told me personally that if you get some money, print books. That's what I am stressing on this point. Where is book, where is book, where is book? So kindly help me. This is my request. Print as many books in as many languages and distribute throughout the whole world. Then Krishna consciousness movement will automatically increase. Now the educated, learned scholars are appreciating our movement by reading books, by taking practical results. Dr. Stilson Jula, he has written one book, perhaps you know. Krishna, Hare Krishna and Counter Culture. a very nice book about our movement, and he's giving importance. He has admitted that, Swamiji, you have done wonderful thing because you have turned the drug-addicted hippies into devotees of Krishna and they are prepared for the service of humanity. So, this movement is so important. We are giving the best service to the humanity. They are plunged into ignorance. All they are rascals, mura. It is not our manufactured word. Krishna says, Namāna viskidanam mūrhā prapadyante narānava. So we have this testing. If we see one has no information of Krishna, then he is mūrhā. We have got to study more. Whether he is Krishna conscious, whether he has got any portion of his heart attached to Krishna. Krishna means attraction. So whether he has been attracted by Krishna, that is our natural position, to become attracted by Krishna. Krishna means all attraction. Just like the magnetic stone attracts the iron. It is natural. And if the iron is covered with dirt, then it does not become attractive. So this is the test to make people prepared for being attracted by Krishna. This is Krishna consciousness. They are by nature nitya-siddha Krishna-bhakti. It is not unnatural. Otherwise, how you European, American, you are so much attracted to Krishna? If Krishna is artificial and Krishna consciousness is artificial something, so how you should be attracted? That they are surprised. They are attractive because that attraction is there already. We are trying simply to have it. Sabanadi Suddha Chitta Kara Yudha. The matter is already there. Just like the young man and young woman. The attraction is already there. Nitya Chitta. It is natural. And when they come near, talk little confidentially, that attraction increases. Not that an artificial attraction. Similarly, our attraction for Krishna is already there. Therefore, that is the Vrindavan picture. Vrindavan, everything is attracted with Krishna. That is Vrindavan. The animals, the trees, the flowers, the land, and the cowherd boys, the elderly cowherd men, Kanda Maharaj and others, all are attracted with Krishna. This is Vrindavan. The Jamuna water, everything, fruits, flowers and everything. That is Vrindavan. The Krishna is the center of attraction. You might have read that when Brahma stole all Krishna's associates, he created himself again, all of them, and everyone is feeling more attracted by Krishna. So this is natural, this is not unnatural. Our position is, natural position is to be attracted by Krishna. If you do not become attracted by Krishna, that is unnatural. And to become attracted by Krishna, that is not unnatural, that is natural. So we want to revive our natural position, uncovered position. Now we are covered by dust, by dirt, by corroding materials. So you have to clean this. Therefore the bhakti process is sarvapadhi vinibhaktam. I am thinking, you are thinking, this is a dirty thing, covering the spirit soul. So you have to clean this. Rishikena rishika, sarvapadhi vinibhaktam tatparatena nirmalam. Nirmalam means cleansed. When we become clean of all dirty things, a material modes of nature, then we are prepared to serve Krishna. That is one. That we do not become zero, sunnavadi. No, we become cleansed. And as soon as we become cleansed, we clean senses when you serve Krishna, that is one. Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanam Bhaktiricha. So this process, the Sevanam Kirtanam, this is the process of cleansing. The more you chant, more you hear, the more you become cleansed, more you become Krishna conscious. Just prolong this process and be happy. Thank you very much.
The following is an arrival address given.
So, very powerful arrival address by Srila Prabhupada. And some very nice points made. Now, we're going to hear a little bit from the Srila Prabhupada. The Srila Prabhupada Lilamrita. So I'd like to ask Bhakti Tom if he could come up and read for us, as as my voice is a little distorted at the moment.
Near the end of 1972, the BBT newsletter, now compiled by Karandara's assistant Rameshvara, reported the ever-increasing results of book distribution. Book distribution continues soaring to all-time highs as more than 25 traveling Sankirtan parties roam the countryside, affecting the lives of hundreds of thousands of conditioned souls. Since mid-September, we have distributed over 15,000 complete Krishna trilogy sets. And since mid-August, we have distributed over 9,000 soft Bhagavad Gitas and over 950 hard Bhagavad Gitas. Macmillan 2 is completely sold out, 20,000 Gitas sold commercially, and is reprinting large quantities for the Christmas rush. Another breakthrough for book distribution came at the end of 1972. The previous year, devotees had taken advantage of the Christmas season by selling the Krishna book door to door, but no one had been aware just how significant the Christmas season could actually be. Rameshvara says, "It was on December 22, 1972, that we accidentally discovered the Christmas marathon in Los Angeles. Of course, we noticed a great increase in the number of people going into the stores, and the stores were staying open sometimes until midnight. I was standing in front of a Burbank Zodis. We were having an intense competition with prizes in Los Angeles, and it was building up to a feverish pitch. So, after distributing madly all day long, I'd collected about $350 and had distributed 650 magazines. It was about 10 o'clock at night. I was convinced this was the new world's record in ISKCON, and that nobody was possibly going to beat me to this day. Even though the store was open until 12, business had started slowing off, and I was thinking, maybe I should go back. Undoubtedly, everybody is back already. No one has ever stayed out past 8 o'clock. They'll all be waiting up for me. I shouldn't keep them waiting up. So in this way, my mind was convincing me to go back. By 11 o'clock, the store was completely dead. I got in the car and started driving back. On the way back, I passed another Zodis called Hollywood Zodis on Sunset and Western. I was torn whether to stop or not, but because that store was crowded and was going to be open until midnight. But I decided, no, I'll go back, because the other devotees will be waiting up to see how many books I distributed, so I just kept driving. I finally arrived at the temple at about 11:50, and I burst into the Sankirtan room. But the only person there was the secretary, Madhukantha. I said, oh no, everyone went to bed? He said, no, nobody's back yet. I was the first one back. That was the discovery of the first Christmas marathon. It was completely unplanned. No one had ever instructed anybody to stay out that late. We just did it spontaneously. Finally, at about 1:30 in the morning, all the devotees had returned, and we were all sitting around looking at the Sankirtan map. We couldn't sleep. We were excited to go out. We were thinking, where can we find plenty of conditioned souls to distribute books to? Our noise and raucous laughter was like a drunken party, and it woke up Karantara, who was sleeping in his office in the next room. He came stumbling in, wiping the sleep from his eyes, but when he saw us and saw what was going on, he burst out laughing and sent us all to bed, saying, get ready for tomorrow. So in this way, we performed the 3-day marathon, December 22nd, 23rd, and 24th. Nobody had ever distributed as many books before in the history of our movement. A big day had been considered to be somewhere between 25 and 40 books, but we were distributing between 5,000 and 6,000 pieces of literature a day for a 3-day period. One temple had distributed almost 18,000 pieces of literature in just 3 days. At this time, Srila Prabhupada was in Bombay, where his attempt to secure the land in Juhu had become entangling. The landlord was now refusing to sell the property and was trying to evict the devotees, even though Srila Prabhupada had already installed Radha Krishna deities on the land. Although these matters were causing Srila Prabhupada anxiety, he continued his usual daily duties, taking his morning walk, lecturing in the evening from the Nectar of Devotion, corresponding with and receiving news from his centers all around the world, and even organizing a Bombay Pandal festival for January. When Prabhupada received news of the book distribution in Los Angeles and somewhere and elsewhere in the United States, he was very pleased and amazed. Although involved with many affairs from throughout the world, he put them aside and relished the overwhelming victory of book distribution in America. Immediately, he called in his personal secretary and dictated letters. My dear Rameshwara, I beg to acknowledge receipt of your letter dated December 27, 1972, and with great happiness I have read your figures of amounts of books sold during the 3-day period, December 22 to 24, 1972. It is scarcely believable that more than 70,000 books could have been sold by one temple in 3 days. That indicates to me that people are at last becoming a little serious about this Krishna consciousness movement in your country. Otherwise, why should they buy our books? But they can see that our boys and girls, devotees, are so much sincere and serious to distribute the message of Krishna consciousness that they are at once struck by seeing them, and therefore they appreciate and purchase them. This is unique in the world. So, I'm so much pleased upon all of the boys and girls in Los Angeles and all over the world who are understanding and appreciating this unique quality of our transcendental literature, and voluntarily they're going out to distribute despite all circumstances of difficulty. By this effort alone, they are assured to go back home, back to Godhead. The same day, Prabhupada dictated a letter to Karandara. He said, I could never have thought it was possible to distribute so many of our literatures. Therefore, I can understand it is simply Krishna's blessing for us blessing us for your sincerely working on his behalf. Actually, this is the secret of my success, not that I personally have done anything wonderful, but that because those who are helping me are sincere, they have done the work. That is the reason for our success all over the world where others have failed. A little sincerity is a very difficult thing in this age of hypocrisy and bluff, but I am so fortunate that Krishna has sent me all of you nice boys and girls who are sincerely working. Please convey to all of them my deepest appreciation. Jai. Jai. Srila Prabhupada's letters acknowledging this Christmas marathon and assuring the devotees that they would go back to Godhead sent the book distribution movement flying into the new year with great momentum. Devotees continued to find new ways and places to distribute books. New records were constantly topping the old, and the devotees were still making higher projections for the future. Rameshwara published in his February 1973 newsletter a letter from a college student who had read one of Srila Prabhupada's books. ISKCON's mail order service was receiving hundreds of letters a month. Sir, a couple of weeks ago, devotees of Krishna from Denver, I understand, were here at the University of Arkansas distributing literature. One young man approached me with a hard pitch for my purchasing a copy of Prabhupada's translation of the Bhagavad Gita. I was initially quite skeptical. So many people are getting rich from selling their versions of The Answer, and told him not to bother me. He insisted though, and I finally gave in. I have been reading the Gita, having not finished it yet, and have found it quite rewarding. My mind, shaped in logic and empiricism, seems to find itself barely tasting the transcendental material in the book. I discuss it with others. I find myself remembering certain passages. It has genuinely stimulated my interest, to say the least, in a way that my quite extensive readings in Christianity, Zen Buddhism, the lower forms of yoga, etc., have never succeeded in doing. And in short, I think I have finally found the beginning. Rameshwara went on to beat the drum of Sankirtan. Actually, nobody can properly measure the effect of our book distribution. If it was known how many books we distribute each month, we would be listed on every bestseller list in the country. For example, as many of you know, already the Gita has outsold any other edition of the Gita ever printed. The Macmillan Company has already sold tens of thousands of copies, while we have sold over 20,000 copies ourselves since they first appeared last August. With increased monies coming into the book fund, Srila Prabhupada has approved his trustees' plans to print larger quantities of books and store them in a warehouse, making them available to the temples for distribution throughout the year. Yet keeping up with the temple's demand for books was still difficult, even with a warehouse. Small, easy-to-sell books like Beyond Birth and Death, On the Way to Krishna, Raj Vidya, The Perfection of Yoga were printed in tens of thousands. Distributors would go out carrying in their bags a variety of books. Sri Ishapanishad, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, and Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as well as an assortment of small books, Back to Godhead magazines, and some inexpensive books like Krishna, The Reservoir of Pleasure, and On Chanting Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada Transcendental Book Distribution Ki Jai.
Does anyone have any comments or anything they would like to like to add? Okay. So anyway, today is the anniversary, I think 42 years since the first Christmas marathon, and it's been extended for the past several years for a lot longer than 3 days, as we can as we can see the effects of many people going out and shopping and doing so many things at Christmas time. So we are continuing in this spirit to try and distribute Srila Prabhupada's books for the remaining 3 days of the marathon. Srila Prabhupada's Transcendental Book Distribution Marathon, K. Srila Prabhupada, K. Okay, so Tom, would you like to read the scores? So I'm probably making everyone feel ill.
Okay. So, from Govinda's restaurant, we have 49 Lakshmi points and sales of 96 customers. 949 Lakshmi points and 96 customers.
That's
Arrivo. Arrivo. And in Radha's Batik, we have our Closet Krishna. We have 12 small books, 4 medium, 1 big, and 12 Maha big books for 171 Lakshmi points. And Radha's Batik, we have 10 books for 300 Lakshmi points. Arrivo. We have the Sankirtan scores here. So we have Dad's Army going out, doing 20 Lakshmi points, 20 medium for 10 book points. Arriba. Dalmora Das, 41 Lakshmi points, 9 medium, 5 Maha big for 17 book points. Correction, sorry. 10.5 book points. Okay, Bhakta Kleber, 36 Lakshmi points, 14 medium, 5 Maha big for 17 book points. Bhakta Tom, 42 Lakshmi, 36 medium, and 1 Maha big for 20 book points. Bhakta Vayu, 44 Lakshmi points, 4 medium, 9 Maha big for 20 book points. Bhakta Sami, 55 Lakshmi points, 12 medium, 4 big, and 5 Maha big for 20 book points. Jainatai Das and Bhava Bhakti Menti group. Oh no, Devi Dasi, sorry. 52 Lakshmi points, 12 medium, and 10 Maha big for 26 Lakshmi points, book points. Sorry. Bhava Bhakti's Menti group. 62 Lakshmi points, 9 medium, and 12 Maha big for 28.5 book points. Bhaktanir, 72 Lakshmi points, 7 medium, and 15 Maha big for 33.5 book points. Bhakta Pasha, 92 Lakshmi points, 23 medium, and 13 Maha big for 37.5 book points. Plumstead Sankirtan, 120 Lakshmi points, 4 small, 8 medium, 6 big, and 15 Maha big for 42 book points. Bhakta Nimai, 91 Lakshmi points, 20 medium, 16 Maha big for 42 book points. Radhika Girls, 160 Lakshmi point, 19 small, 30 medium, 9 Maha big, 9 big, 15 Maha big for 58.75 book points. Bhakta Rajesh, 178 Lakshmi points, 21 medium, 11 Maha big, and 1 set for 66.75 book points. Coming in at number 2, Nam Sankirtan Das, 173 Lakshmi points, 4 medium, and 38 Maha big for 78 book points. Number 1, Vamsidhari Das, 397 Lakshmi points, 79 medium, 2 big, and 71 Maha big for 183.5 book points. Total of 16 devotees going out for 1,635 Lakshmi points, 23 small books, 308 medium books, 27 big, and 236 Maha big for, and 1 set for 693 book points. Bhava Transcendental Book Distribution Key.
Bhakta Tom Prabhu King. Okay, so carrying on with the last 3 days of the marathon, and we are now we have officially also surpassed in total our score from last year, not just during the marathon, but for the whole year. So we have already increased upon and improved on last year, but our target for this marathon was 52,000 Lakshmi points worth of books, and we are at 44,000. So 3 days. 3 days. Actually, it's 44.8, so it's closer to 45. So that's about 7,000 Lakshmi points worth of books in 3 days equals 2-5 each day, kind of thing, right? 2-3, 2-2. So, anyway, Srila Prabhupada's score still hasn't been turned in, and Klausa Krishna still has another big score to turn in, and all of us still have the opportunity to go out and try to do some book distribution. So, for these last 3 days, whatever we can do to try to distribute Srila Prabhupada's books, and then as the Bhagavad Gita explains, you know, we leave the result up to the Lord. We'll just endeavor as much as we can. So, okay, so there aren't many devotees this morning for breakfast, so that should be pretty easy. And just when we need a big Sankirtan devotee, Radha Charan Prabhu arrives. Hadivo! So he has not turned in his Sankirtan score yet either. And for the last 3 days, he will be distributing maximum numbers of books for the pleasure of Shishi Radha Vandaneshwar and their devotees. Radha Charan Prabhu Ki! Okay, so we'll offer our prayer to their lordships. Dear Shishi Radha Vandaneshwar, Jagannath Baladev and Subhadra, Shishi Gaur Nitai, and Giri Govardhan, we offer our most respectful obeisances unto you. With a mood of deep gratitude and appreciation, we request your causeless mercy upon us. For your pleasure, if you so desire, we wish to erect a holy place of your transcendental pastimes that will attract unlimited souls to your service and fulfill the vision of your pure devotee Srila Prabhupada for London. Please enable us to cooperate together in order to satisfy you in this way. And please, please, please help us to distribute thousands and thousands more of Srila Prabhupada's transcendental literatures during this marathon. We, your surrendered servants, humbly beg. Srila Prabhupada's transcendental book distribution, ki! New temple for the lordships, ki! Okay, so if we can all help to bring the prasadam up from downstairs, and then devotees can volunteer to serve. We also need volunteers to help clean up the temple room after breakfast. Anyone who can volunteer for that service? Okay, thank you. Anyone else who can help with that? Cleaning up the temple room? Okay. All right, if everyone could please help to bring the prasadam up. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Last 3 days of the marathon, ki jai.